Hello everyone. So today we are here to learn something interesting. So if we observe, you know, our daily life, we see a lot of signs around us. Now, you must be wondering, what is science? Science is nothing but systematic study of facts or truths through observations and experimentation. Now, to be a little clear about what science is, science can be further divided into biology. What is biology? Biology is nothing but study of behavioral pattern of living organisms, their origin, etc. For example, right now you are able to hear me and see me at the same time, and you are able to process this information and you are able to understand it. Now that is a part of biology. Although there are various fields in biology, I just gave you a small example. Likewise, there is physics. What is this physics? Physics is study of energy and how it behaves with the physical world. Now you can see that we are far away from each other right now, but still you're able to see me. How you're able to see me on a screen? There's a lot of energy involved in it. It can be sound energy, light energy, electrical energy, etc. So all this play a major role. So even right now I'm speaking, so there is sound energy. I'm able to stand, there is gravitational force of attraction. So various factors, and study of that is physics. And another field of science is chemistry. What is chemistry? Chemistry is study of matter. Okay, chemistry is study of matter. What is matter? Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. For example, let us take this water bottle. Okay, so it is having some mass and it is occupying some space. So you can see me that it is occupying some space and it has some mass. So we can call this as a matter. Okay, so what is chemistry? Chemistry is study of matter. So today's class we'll be discussing more about matter, and the chapter name is matter and its composition. Matter and its composition. A very important chapter. Matter and its composition. Now you all have understood what is matter. Anything that occupies space and has mass is called as matter. Furthermore, if you consider matter, matter is made up of tiny particles. Okay, matter is made up of tiny particles, and these particles are called as atoms or molecules. You will learn more about atoms and molecules in coming sessions. Okay, so let us just understand what is matter made up of. Matter is made up of tiny particles called as atoms and molecules. Okay, these atoms or molecules are arranged in different fashion. Okay, so based on how these particles are arranged in a given space, we can classify matter into three different types, that is solids, liquid and gas. Okay, so how are we classifying this? Based on the different properties. Okay, so we can classify matter into three different states, that is solids, liquids and gases. Let us understand how it is classified based on different properties, and let us do a comparative study. It's a very important part for CBSE students as well as ICSE students and also state students. Okay, how, based on how particles are packed. Okay, so in a given space, okay, if this is a given space, how particles are arranged, based on that we can classify matter into solid, liquid or gas. If the particles are very closely packed, okay, if the particles are closely packed, then the state in which the matter exists is solids. Okay, if particles are loosely packed, liquids, and very loosely packed. Okay, hardly you can see few particles in a given space, so that they are gases, very loosely packed. Coming to interparticular distance, the distance between two particles. Now, in just imagine, in case of solid, particles are very close to each other. Particles are very close to each other. What will be the interparticular distance? Distance between two particles will be minimum. When we move on to liquids, the distance will be comparatively higher, right? In case of gases, the distance between the particles will be maximum. Coming to the force of attraction, right? If the particles are very close to each other, what will happen to the force of attraction? If there are two particles, for example, let us take this chalk piece, okay? These are two particles. They're very close to each other. That means the interparticular distance is minimum and the force of attraction between these two particles will be maximum, right? So force of attraction will be maximum. Whereas for liquid, it will be less than solid. The attraction, as the particles move far away from each other, what happens? The attraction decreases. And for gases, the attraction between two particles will be minimum because they are very far away from each other. Coming to the shape and volume. Solids have definite shape and volume, whereas liquids have indefinite shape. They can take the shape of the container, so they don't have any definite shape, but they have definite volume, right? So how can you say they have definite volume? You can weigh it, you can measure it, right? 500 ml 1000 ml, so it has definite volume. Coming to gas, they don't have definite shape nor definite volume, okay? So they don't have any definite shape or volume. Coming to the rigidity or fluidity, because particles are closely arranged, here solids are rigid, they cannot flow. Liquids, yes, they can flow, but they are less than the flow. Fluidity is less than gases. Gases can flow very easily and fluidity is higher compared to other states. Kinetic energy, the energy possessed by a moving body, okay? See here, kinetic energy will be minimum because the particles are confined in one place and they cannot move easily. So kinetic energy will be minimum. Whereas in case of liquids, kinetic energy will be higher than solids because they can move little freely. And in case of gas, kinetic energy will be highest. Coming to compressibility. Compressibility, solids are incompressible. Liquids are almost compressible and gases are highly compressible. Rate of diffusion is very low in case of solids, higher than solid when we come to liquids, and it will be highest in gas. Now what is diffusion? Diffusion is spreading of particles, okay? So that is diffusion. Diffusion will be highest in case of gases. Gases can spread easily in the given space, and it will be, compared to solids, liquids will be having higher diffusibility and solid will be having least diffusibility. Diffusibility is nothing but spreading of particles, that is rate of diffusion. So this is about comparative study of three different states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. Furthermore, if you go, there are different states, for example plasma state, and that is called as fourth state of matter, and there is also called as fifth state of matter, that is Bose-Einstein condensate. So you go back and do little research about it. We will discuss that in coming sessions, okay? Now we know that matter has kinetic energy, right? Even solid particles have kinetic energy. They will be moving in their own place, okay? Just they'll be having kinetic energy. All the matter particles of matter will be having kinetic energy. Now let us try to understand the different states of matter based on their kinetic energy. And it is explained by kinetic theory of matter. Kinetic theory of matter. So, if you consider matter, a matter is made up of, all the matter is made up of tiny particles called as atoms or molecules. So, tiny particles called atoms or molecules. This is the first point in the theory, okay, in the kinetic theory. All matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms or molecules. Now, these atoms or molecules are in constant motion. They are constantly moving. Because of that, they possess kinetic energy. Kinetic energy. The particles have kinetic energy because they are continuously moving. Okay. Now, this kinetic energy is directly proportional to, I'll just write the short form, kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. What does it mean? If kinetic energy increases, temperature will also increase. Other words, if I decrease the temperature, even kinetic energy will decrease. That is the meaning of directly proportional. Now, kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. If kinetic energy increases, temperature also increases. If kinetic energy decreases, temperature also decreases. So, this is the third point. Okay. Now, what happens if kinetic energy increases? Particles will start moving very fastly. As a result, particles will go away from each other. Particles will go away from each other. As a result, the distance between the particles, the distance between the particles will increase. That is, interparticular distance increases. If distance increases, what will happen? If distance increases, force of attraction will be minimal. Force of attraction decreases. If distance increases, force of attraction decreases. If kinetic energy, okay, decreases, what happens? Particles will start moving slowly. They start coming closer to each other. As a result, interparticular distance reduces. Distance between the particles decreases. Force of attraction increases. Okay, force of attraction increases if distance between the particle decreases. So, this is the fourth point. Okay. If the force of attraction is between the similar particles, okay, if the force of attraction is between the similar particles, now I am taking example of two chocolates, they look similar, okay. If the force of attraction is between two similar particles, it is called as cohesive force of attraction. Cohesive force of attraction. Okay, it is between the two similar particles. If it is between dissimilar particles, okay, so I will take these two particles, okay. So, this is yellow in color, or let us take other chalk for more, it will be more evident. So, one I have blue color and then other. So, it is dissimilar. Let us consider that it is dissimilar. So, these are two different particles, and if the force of attraction is between two dissimilar particles, then we call such force of attraction as adhesive force of attraction. Okay, let me just recall whatever we have done so far with kinetic energy. Kinetic energy, first point is all the matter is made up of tiny particles called as atoms or molecules. These atoms or molecules are in constant motion. As a result, they possess kinetic energy. And kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. If temperature increases, kinetic energy increases. If temperature decreases, kinetic energy also decreases. Now, what happens if kinetic energy increases? Particles move far away from each other. The distance between the particle increases and force of attraction decreases. And if kinetic energy decreases, particles come closer to each other. If particles come closer to each other, what happens? Distance decreases and force of attraction increases. And the last point is, if the force of attraction is between the similar particles, then it is cohesive force of attraction. If it is between dissimilar particles, then it is adhesive force of attraction. I hope this concept is clear. This is also important for ICSE board. Now, let us move on with the interconversion of states. What is this interconversion of states? We know that there are different states, and all the states can be interconverted. We can convert solid to liquid or liquid to gas, or from gas to liquid or liquid to solid. Now, that is called as interconversion of state, the phenomena in which a substance can change its state. When can a substance change its state? When we change conditions like temperature, when there is changes in temperature or pressure, matter can change its state. Like, let us understand this. Let us understand this. Let me take solid. Okay, so I'm writing S for solid. The process of conversion of solid to liquid, okay, is called as melting. Okay, this is effect of temperature. Let us take temperature first. Okay, now I have a solid with me, for example ice, and am providing temperature. It will get converted to liquid, and we call that process as melting. We have now water, liquid. If we continue heating, if you continue increasing the temperature, it undergoes vaporization. It undergoes vaporization to become gas. Okay, the process of conversion of liquid to gas is called as vaporization. Similarly, if there is conversion from gas to liquid, it is called as condensation. And from liquid to solid, it is called as freezing. Right? So you have liquid, you can freeze it and get it converted to solid. Similarly, if you have gas, it can get converted to liquid. So where do you see this process? This process is seen in early morning dew drops. Right? So dew drops is an example for condensation. Right? Then there is another type of conversion in which solid directly gets converted to gas without going through liquid state. And we call it as sublimation. Right? It is called as sublimation. For example, you can keep camphor, you can take camphor, naphthalene balls, etc. as example. So, solid directly gets converted to gas. Similarly, gas can directly get converted to solid without going through liquid state. We call it as deposition. Okay? Or desublimation. So, example is formation of dry ice, like you have carbon dioxide gaseous form, you can get by decreasing the temperature, what will happen? It can get converted to solid. So this is about interconversion of states of matter. So you can convert the matter to different states by altering pressure and temperature. The phenomena in which there is conversion of matter from one state to another state due to changes in temperature and pressure is called as interconversion of state. So, in next session, we will learn more about interconversion of state and how we can represent it graphically. Okay, so that is for this session. Thank you. We'll see.